Tell you. Thank you. I want to also know that we're prepared for the upcoming Holy Mission Council. It's a matter of days now. Coming up fast. We need to learn how to prepare for it. We've heard this all our life. This is very well said all the time. Prepare. We need to learn to prepare. We have many people flying, which is great. I'm glad to see that they got good deals. We still have a bus which I had chartered way back in July. Amen. And we're looking for people to fill that bus. Amen. It's simple as that. So if you can, and you want to go, and you need a ride, see Sister Cherise. I always did say Peggy something, but Greece. Because we're in good standing with that bus company. And they trust us, and when a church gives a word, that means something. We have to rebuild our reputation. We can't be known in a church that are slackers, not untrustworthy. We need to be the people of God. We are doing things like you think we are doing. I do it the way I'm planning to do it. We have so many gifts in the church, so many talents in the church. And music has a way of breaking spirits. One man can't do it all. When Saul had all those spirits working in him, and demons terrorizing his soul, a young lad played a harp. See, I don't believe in certain things. Music ain't just something that just makes you feel good. Music got a message in it. When music has a message in it, when it's ordained by the Lord, and I could hear in that music, I got some help. The ears don't hear, but I can hear some deliverance in it. Through the keys, through when it went up and the down. Right where we are right now, I can see them uplifting me. Music talks to my soul. We say it, we say it. The Pentecostal come down, we live by the Spirit, then we need to be led by the Spirit. Amen. We were talking on Sunday, on Friday night, in the 24th chapter of Psalms, about the earth being the Lord. The message went out. God said His word. But I'm afraid so many people have missed it. I can tell from the knocks on the door. Many people have missed it. I can see it in the eyes. Many people have looked. We're going to go over this. One thing in teaching, you can go over it until you get it right. Young people did a good job with it. Wonderful job. That's why I say if you feel they're going to hold you long, because people have to leave, go home, and I want to be able to eat. But I want you to eat this first. Thank God for such amazing meal in our midst, reading for us. Everyone in the household of faith. All the visitors, well-wishers, I'm glad you're here. Amen. Now, good. We're not going to go into all detail that we did on Friday. We're going to give it a quick.
Psalms 24:1.
Psalms 24:1.
The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof.
I've heard that people expound on it. We talked on it. Young people talked on it. Somewhere you got to believe this. It's not a visit here on Friday night or Sunday. You didn't go back home and Monday, everything is still the same. The word needs to change you. The church is a place that when you come here, you should leave here strong. Not weaker, but stronger.
Amen.
Not with more doubt, but with more faith.
Amen.
The word is preached with faith. First, I gotta believe it.
Yes, sir.
If I don't believe it, I can't preach it.
Amen.
Or I can say it.
Yes, sir.
See, that's the problem. We got a lot of preachers that preach it, but they don't fully believe it themselves.
Amen.
Spirit of their unbelief is mingled in the message and appears.
sir.
That you got the champion in you.
Yes, sir.
The Lord, the Master, is he your Lord?
Yeah.
When he said that, is he your Lord? I mean, I want to assume nothing. Is he your Lord? Is he your Father? Is he your refuge? Is he your salvation? But any poison that goes to your mind, he's the antidote.
Yes, sir.
The Lord. Beating us up, making us feel